Hello everyone, welcome to MA Consulting. Good evening, hope you are doing well. Today our agenda, you are going to learn SAP SuccessFactors Employee Central Organization Structure Object Association and Filter Concept. I would recommend you to watch this video till the end, and if you are new here, please consider to subscribe our channel down below and hit the bell icon to get any future updates. Now we are going to discuss an example with a configuration scenario. A pharmaceutical company has three business units called Drug, Clinical Development and R&D. The drug business unit has three divisions associated to it called Asia, Middle East and Europe, while the clinical development business unit has two divisions associated to it called Asia and Middle East, and the third one is R&D business unit has two divisions associated to it called Europe and Middle East. Now, we have four types of foundation object association. One is MDF to MDF, MDF foundation object to MDF foundation object, example division to business unit. The next one is MDF foundation object to XML foundation object. An example, we have legal entity to location. The third one is XML foundation object to XML foundation object. And in example, we have geo zone to location. And the last one is XML to MDF, XML foundation object to foundation object. Now, what is association? It's a feature to link foundation object or MDF foundation object, which help us to filter the child field in job information portlet based on a parent field. We have two types of association. One is bottom to top approach, which is valid one. This is used for organization structure related objects. And the other one is top to bottom approach. We have composite. This is used for custom MDF related custom portlet in employee screen. Now, what is parent child concept? Parent, this is the field which is selected first in job information portlet. Child, the field which gets filtered based on parent object. Below steps explain how association an MDF object to another MDF object happens. First, we will create object level association at the backend in configure object definition between the objects. The next one is configure field criteria, which is done at the front end in manage business configuration. And the third one is maintain association data, filter data. Now I will take you into the system to see the live demonstration of this example and how to configure in the system. Here we write configure object definition in search section. Here in organization object to object association, we use bottom to top approach. I mean, we will do association of parent object in child object. So for that, we will first select object definition and then search for business unit, which is our child object. Okay, click on take action, and on take action, click on make correction and come to bottom. You will see association area. Here, name to which the object are going to associate, here write the name like to legal entity. This is a free text field. You can write anything you want. Then next thing we have multiplicity. We always use one to many because the parent can have multiple child. The next field is destination object. Destination object is the parent object in which child object is being associated, and the last thing is valid one. When parent should exist, then the child must be exist. So that's why we will use valid one. And on detail, we will give a meaningful name in the label. Like here we have legal entity for business unit. Click on done. Click on save. Note, association configuration is always created within the child object related to organizational objects. If you want to have multiple department for one legal entity, then it should be one to many, else it's one to one. Now, this is backend organizational object level association is done. Now coming towards the front end configuration to function the object properly. So for that, we'll come to system again, and in search section, we will write manage business configuration. Click on manage business configuration. Let us duplicate this tab. Okay, and on manage business configuration, here we have a portlet called job information. Click on job information. Okay, on the job information portlet, you can find company as legal entity and business unit. Click on detail in the business unit. Scroll down, and on scroll down you will find field criteria. Here you have two fields, destination field and source field. Destination field value, enter the standard job information field ID of parent object. Here parent is company in my example. Source field name, enter the association name with an extension. This part is a bit confusing and any mistakes here will result in filtering issue. First we will write the destination field, and on destination field we have company, and on source field go to parent object definition and check the label internal code under column database field name. For standard object we will use internal ID, and for custom we will use MDF system internal code. This will be the extension. To get the source field we will go back to configure object definition on the same object business unit, and at the bottom copy this free text field name and on here paste it with the name CUST as same name we have there, cust underscore legal entity dot. So to connect from front end to back end we need extension which is internal ID. This internal ID will connect both from front end to back end and will be is for our data filtration process. So here this internal ID, copy this internal ID name and paste it here. Now we have properly established our connection between front end and back end and done association at the front end level too. Click on done and save this. After save, now the third step is maintain association data. So to maintain the data we will go to manage data, duplicate this step, and on search section write manage data. And here we will get any business unit. For example, on here create new business unit with effective date, start date as of today. Business unit code is MAH underscore BU1. Business unit name, description, I will take this the same as the description is active. Head of unit, and on legal entity. Now I have to choose the legal entity, so here for this I will choose legal entity as best run 1000 and click on save. Now this business unit, MA business unit, is belong to this legal entity best run 1000. Now the fourth step is to verify the configuration. So to verify the configuration we will go to employee file, on employee file click on action and change job compensation information. Click on job information give this effective date as today, 25. And on organizational information, let me choose first Western 1000. If it will allow me to choose okay, this is showing some kind of glitch in the system. Come to manage data, duplicate. Cancel this and on change job compensation information. To proper work of our scenario, let me copy this company name and assign our business unit to this so we can see the data impact. Come to manage data. And here we will search business unit. And here we will search for our business unit, which is MH. To change, click on take action, make correction. And here on legal entity, I will delete this entry. And again, I will assign this company 1710 best run to this business unit. Okay, click on save. Now let's take a look at the impact. Click on refresh. Okay, it's safe. And let me check the impact of the data. Did we get or not? Click on action. Change job compensation information. Job information and 25 April. Okay. Now let's find the business unit. Okay, here. As you can see, MA business unit, MH underscore BU1. We have got this business unit. Before it was not coming. Why? Because we didn't have filtered this data, as this company is not assigned to this business unit. So when we assign this company to this business unit in managed data, as you can see, legal entity best run company 1710. And this business unit is under this company, Peston company 1710. So now this data is coming as filter data here. This MA business unit. So right now we are seeing this MDF to MDF association. We have another kind of association, which is MDF to XML association. Here we have the XML of this scenario, HRIS association, association ID equal to ID and multiplicity as one to many. And destination entity is legal entity, our company, and required equal to false. As we have This association is for location group. Sorry, for location. So we have parent object is legal entity and child object is location. So we have this scene also MDF to XML association. The next scenario is XML to XML association. Here we have both of the object is as XML association, not MDF. Location is also XML dependent object and geozone is also XML dependent object. So here we have HRIS association, association ID equal to ID, multiplicity 1:1, destination entity is geozone, required equal to false. And here we have closing our opening tag of HRIS association. So we have covered this topic as per our audience request. If anyone want any specific scenario based topic to be covered, they can suggest me in our comment section and I will make the video on that topic. Thank you.